don't do science, and somehow it's not for them. But looking around today and looking and seeing the role models, it just shows that it's just not true. It's not boring, and it's not for, you know, just for boys either. And outside of this room as well, we also have some absolutely incredible female role models. Francis didn't say this, but for the first time, the presidents of the Royal Society of Chemistry, the Society of Biology, and the Institute of Physics are all women. And she was also telling me beforehand that I think the Society of Maths and various others as well have also got women at the head of them. And that's really showing that we're breaking new ground. And it's really great that there are some really inspirational women working in STEM careers, providing leadership to younger girls coming along as well. And the government is really committed to getting more girls doing STEM subjects. And there's quite a lot that we're doing to promote careers in STEM subjects, to encourage people to take them up. So for example, last month the Chancellor launched the STEM diversity campaign. And as part of the campaign, there are more than 170 companies and organisations that have signed up to making it easier to recruit and retain more women in science and maths careers, and that they have made a commitment that they're going to do that themselves. So they've made sort of different pledges. So for example, L'Oreal has committed £155,000 in fellowships and support for female scientists over the next 2 years. So actually making sure that there's money there to back up women going into those jobs. Google is involved as well, and they're committed to running a competition to inspire girls to take up coding, which is another area of the work. And on top of that, in September we're launching a media campaign, which is aimed at encouraging 14 to 16 year olds, which I think most of you in this room are, to take up STEM subjects at A level, to try and get more girls in particular to take that step. So rather than just doing GCSEs, to take sciences forward to A level as well. And part of that campaign will be highlighting the range of different careers that you can do if you've studied STEM subjects, showing that some of them are really, really interesting, and there's a whole variety of different things out there. The government wants to make the most of female talent. We really need to in society, and that begins with students having access to good quality careers advice and being well supported by teachers when you're making the decisions about what you're going to study. So I think it's absolutely great that we have the Opening Doors launch this morning. The Institute of Physics has decades of experience of encouraging and promoting physics, and we're working with them to launch this pilot scheme. And it builds on the findings of a report that they did called Closing Doors, Exploring Gender and Subject Choice in Schools, which found that nearly half of all mixed state schools have no girls studying A-level physics at all, which I think is really quite a terrifying figure. So we really want to help schools look at this issue in more detail to try and identify what they can do to make a real difference. The pilots that are running can bring together different schools in a local area to look at the culture of the school and the barriers that girls can face when they're making their choices about the subjects they want to do. And the schools are going to be visiting each other and sharing what they've learned as part of that, so we can make some really good progress in getting more girls to study subjects at A level. And I think it will be really helpful to help schools to be able to improve the rate of girls that are taking physics and other STEM subjects at A level, so that we get more girls coming through. There are increasingly more people taking maths and physics A level, but the numbers of girls are still pretty low. And lots of teenagers, including some of the most brilliant female students, don't know about the amazing opportunities that are open up to them if they study maths and physics, and that's something we really need to tackle. Studying those subjects can, it often leads to the highest earnings, which I think a lot of people don't realise, and it can open doors to careers in business, journalism, technology, engineering, sort of pretty much anything that you can think of. And if we can increase the number of girls that are taking up STEM subjects, we'll be giving people the opportunity to become inventors, creators of apps and researchers, but also managers, fashion buyers, TV executives as well. So it really broadens the horizons and gives people lots of opportunities in future careers. It can lead to almost anything. And I really hope that more organisations across business and academia come together to support the campaign and to support the ambition today to make STEM subjects more appealing and more accessible to girls to take at school. There is no such thing as jobs for boys and jobs for girls. It's just jobs for people. And I think the launch today is really demonstrating that. So thank you, the Institute of Physics, for all the work that has been done on this. And thank you for the really inspiring role models that are here today for giving up your time and coming and talking to the girls at the school here. And for everything that you're continuing to do, you're doing now to try and encourage girls to study and then work in STEM subjects. And I think that we are starting to see progress being made. It's a long haul, but there are more girls studying these subjects. There is a long way to go, but I think we are making a real step forward, and I think that project today will make a real difference. So thank you all very much for all the work that you're doing, and good luck in all your choices about what you do in the future. And it would be very nice to see some of you in Parliament as well, particularly if you have a scientific background. Thank you very much.
We have many actually different sub-disciplines within engineering working together. And you can be a designer that helps build robots.